ESPNLA.com. This is Andy Kamenetsky, the Land of Lakers blog, here with my brother Brian.
Hey.
The second round of the playoffs, the Western Conference semifinals, they are upon us. And Sunday afternoon at Staples Center, the Lakers took game one against the Jazz 104-99. The fourth quarter, the Lakers were up by eight, but the second unit, much to everybody, and in particular Lamar Odom's dismay, blew a lead, and it was up to the starters to come out ahead in a dogfight. Both teams played pretty tough down the stretch, but as it turned out, the Lakers are just better than the Jazz, and they're better in a lot of facets that I think became pretty apparent down the game stretch.
Yeah, and there are things that the Jazz are going to have a lot of trouble fixing. The Utah actually was able to get up by four with 4 minutes to play, but from there the Lakers dominated in just about every facet of the game. They controlled things defensively. Utah only one field goal in the final 4 minutes, came with 19 seconds left, and then they, you know, tacked on a couple free throws at the end. But overall, they just couldn't get the ball in the basket. Meanwhile, at the other end, they had trouble stopping Kobe Bryant. They don't have anyone that is a natural matchup for them, like Thabo Sefolosha was in the last round.
Even Kevin Durant or James Harden,
sure,
I think, had better options.
Yeah, Kobe lit up the Jazz down the stretch. And when he missed, the Lakers were able to capitalize. Pau Gasol had a great putback. It was actually a third chance opportunity for the Lakers. Came a little earlier in the fourth quarter. Lamar Odom put back a Kobe miss. They couldn't keep the Lakers off the boards. Couldn't score at the other end. These are things that, like we said, tough to correct over the course of a series. Just a terrible matchup.
Right, and it's exactly why in 2008 the Lakers took out the Jazz. And in 2009, they took out the Jazz. And in 2010, in the playoffs, I expect them to take out the Jazz again. I predicted a five-game series, and it's not because Utah is a really bad team. I mean, I think they're actually a quality
team.
They're good. And they're going to work hard. But in the end, there's just too many mismatches in the Lakers' favor. And when you combine the fact that the Jazz are missing a couple of important players, I just don't think that they're going to be able to overcome really what the Lakers are going to bring, despite, like, say, today, getting up ahead in the fourth quarter and looking like they could pull out a lead. It's just not going to happen.